What if you can write your code 30x faster? You can share the same process to your team members, and even they can speed up their process. This is Kalyan Chatterjee from Black Box Tech. Without further ado, let's get started. I'll be start by creating a custom snippet for this. Let's open preference and then user snippet section. From there, choose the preferred language. I'll be choosing TypeScript for this tutorial. Now, within this object, we'll create our own custom snippet. I'll be starting with a simple custom console logs snippet. The first key is the prefix, which defines the short form of your snippet, and upon writing the snippet and hitting tab, it will be expanded as a complete code. Let's define the name as C-log. The next key is body, where your code will reside. For a single line code, we can use this as a string. My first stop will be the message section, and the second one will be where we want to pass the variable to the log. In the next key, which is description, you can add a description about the code. Now let's test this snippet in an actual file. As I said earlier, the prefix in your snippet will be expanded to place your full code and stop at the first step stop. And when I will hit the tab again, it will stop in the second tab position. This is really helpful when you want to minimize your effort writing repetitive code. Another example, where this platform check can be used in many places to determine if the app is in server or client. Start by copying it and create another snippet. I will give it a name of platform. For the prefix, I will use a short form of PLT. For the body, as our code is multi-line, I will be using it as an array and paste the code inside. I will just remove this part from the snippet, as this needs to be filled by the developer. Now let's make every line a string. This dot platform ID can be different constant, so let's make it editable and as our first step stop. This will be our second step stop. this will be our third one, and this will be our last one defined by 0. Now let's try it out. It stopped at the first step stops. You can pass your constant is dot platform ID. In the second step stop, you can write the conditions. In the second step stop, you can write your else part. The code don't have a proper tab spaces and format, so let's fix that in the snippet. It can be fixed by a /t/. Now if you try, it will be correctly formatted. There is a possibility this is platform server can be changed as is platform browser. So we can also provide an option to choose between these two inside our snippet. Let's make that change. Now let's try it out. You can see, now you can choose from two different options. You can also provide a default options for this .platform ID. Let's make that change. Now let's try it out. My next example is a HTTP service using HTTP client library. Let's create another snippet for this. I'm giving a prefix of HTTP htget. It will be multi-line, so I am taking this as an array. Giving it a description. Let's make this method name editable and as our first step stop for edit. this any is there in the both places. If you provide both the options same name, it can be edited together at the same time. Give it a keyword and our third step stop. And the fourth step stop will be our header options. Define the last step stop with 0. Let's try this out. Another advantage is if you can make also a snippet available with your custom key combination. To make it work, open the keybinding JSON using command plus P and search with keybinding JSON. I have already created an example here which will work along with our custom lock snippet. The key combination I have added is command plus L. The action will be performed when this key combination executed is to insert snippet. And it's very important to match the name as the same name as your snippet. Now let's try it out. These all are global snippet, but if you want, the snippet can be used by other developers for a particular project. Just go to preference, user snippet and choose snippet for that project for which you have already inside that project folder. This is just a simple trick to speed up your process. I will come up with more videos like this. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And also, Happy New Year. Thanks for watching.